Hello everyone, welcome to day 24 of the holiday card series for 2020. I'm so glad you're here. This is the last official live that will be included in the holiday card series, but I will continue with these lives into the new year. Just before we get going into this too far, Christmas is exactly 1 week from today. It happens to be on a Friday, so I won't be live on Christmas Day, but I will have a video that goes up. If you want to tune in and just have a little bit of relaxing time listening to Christmas music and watching some Christmas crafting, it's going to be really low key. I hope you'll join me on Friday for that video. You can watch it whenever you have a chance. Speaking of lives, because I'm not going to be live on Friday, I've decided I'm going to go live next Wednesday. Stay tuned for the time. I'm not sure if I'm going to do it like in the afternoon, like the normal time, or if I wanted to in the evening. I want more of you to be able to participate, so let me know. So hold on, I'm getting a text message. I'm gonna put my phone on do not disturb. There we go. All right, so okay, so today we're doing some crafting. I have very minimal plans for today's cards. I just am enamored with strips of different colors of cardstock, so I thought I would do a little bit of that today. And yeah, I had a conversation with one of my friends, crafting friends, well, two of them actually were wondering about this. Kathy Rack was going to be doing some piecing of strips of paper, and then also I think it was Pocono Pam that asked questions about that. Anyway, so that discussion with them got me thinking about, I thought I'd do that today. So hold on, let me switch to, there we go. Now you can see this. So what I've done is I've picked out some different cardstocks. I have three packs of 6x6 paper here from, this is from Tonic. These are their mixed card packs. I've got Ruby Romance, Gold Hearted, and Green Valley. And I'm just going to pick out maybe like two from each one. I think the glitter would be really pretty. And I'm tearing it. Oh well, that's okay. I'm going to like maybe pick two from each. I love this satin. It's so pretty. Ooh, I'm going to do the bright foil. Trying not to take off the front cover while I'm at it. So foil, glitter. I think I'm gonna have to do the satin too. And maybe I'll just finish using what's left of this right here. All right, as far as the gold goes, let's see, what are my options? We've got kind of a textured metallic. Then we have a glittery one. This one's kind of like has a little bit of a shimmer to it. It's a little of a different tone. And then we have the bright. I think I'm gonna go with, it's kind of textured. I'll just use what's left of this one right here. And shiny one. Natalie's saying it matches my nail polish. It kind of does. All right, and this is the green. You guys saw this in a video not long ago. I think it was just last week. I think I will do the satin green. And I want green to be sort of a more secondary color, so maybe I'll only have that, because I do have some regular cardstock I'll be using too. Okay, so I have those picked out. And then I also have some just regular cardstock colors that I'm going to throw in there with it, because these are just going to be strips of color. And I searched up and down in my craft room for my strips dies from Simon. And I, for the life of me, could not find them. They are missing, they're gone. I don't know where they went. So we are kicking it old school and using a paper trimmer today. I was even planning to break out my manual die cutting machine and everything so I could like still be on camera with you guys, but nope, not today. All right, I'm gonna zoom out a little bit and kind of see the mess on my desk. All right, and I'm just going to, I'm not doing these in any particular width. I just want to try to make them as straight as possible. So there might be some thin ones, thick thin, somewhere between really wide, chunky stripes. Just doing a bunch. I'm planning to make two cards out of all of these strips. So now I really love when all the measurements are the same. I love a card like that, but you know, I don't want to have to deal with it. So we're doing a bunch of different sizes. That is the plan. Let me get rid of my face up here. So there we go. Hello, and hello with everyone. So many people, it's their first live. Welcome. So glad you're joining us today. These plain colors of cardstock are from Hero Arts. I wish I knew the exact color names, but I do not. Let's do a thick one. And then I might be able to get even more than two cards out of this. I think this is a great way to use up a bunch of cardstock. All right, I'm just making sure it's straight. Lots of all the live, all first time live goers. Yay! I wasn't watching the chat when I said it, but let me know, which would you prefer? Do you want next Wednesday's live to be like usual time at noon Mountain time, like right now, but on Wednesday? Or do you want it later in the day? So it would be more evening time for me. I know Gina K usually goes live on Wednesdays at 7 Central, so it would not be during her live, because I wouldn't want to overlap. Okay, now we're on to the specialty cardstock. Ugh, this green is so luscious. You know, I might not even use these greens together. They're, well, I don't know. They might be okay. All right. Ooh, this cuts like a green, too. Most people are saying same time. The first few, anyway. They're all going for same. Most people are saying same. Okay, we will stick with the same then. Of course, I am asking the people who are available at noon in the middle of the day. I'm sure if I was asking other people later, they'd be like, later! Okay, we're gonna go on to the very shiny gold. Oh, this cuts so easily. No wonder it die cuts like a dream. Here's the one with the texture on it. I think I can get more strips going this direction. I might be able to even do a couple this way. All right. Oh, this red satin. So pretty. Look at that. Someone's asking in the chat if I like this trimmer. I really love this trimmer. I've had essentially this trimmer for over 10 years. I used to have the Stampin' Up! Version, which was basically the same. And then I had the unbranded version straight from Tonic. It's orange. And then when Tim came out with his, then I don't think that's a little too short. Then I started using this one. So, but it's been essentially the same trimmer. They just make them different colors or have different branding on them. And I love it. I never have to sharpen it. Sometimes if like I'm not getting a really good cut, I might have to like consciously like make sure I'm kind of pushing the arm in, because normally when there's an issue, that is the problem. So I'm like very conscious of it right now. So I'm making sure to kind of push the arm in as I cut. All right, we'll end there. Getting quite a pile of scraps here. Some people are saying they like the smaller version of this trimmer. I do have the smaller version, but I found that I cut too many cardstocks that are longer than 8.5 inches in length. And so it just makes more sense for me to have the bigger one. That's just me. But if I was like traveling a lot or crafting with friends, I might consider just taking a smaller one with me all the time, because it's a whole lot easier to travel with, that's for sure. Although this one does have the feature where you can remove this arm and you can remove the handle on the arm and store it underneath on the underside of the trimmer. So there are opportunities to kind of make the overall size of the trimmer a little bit more manageable if you're going to be traveling with it. All right, one more. Okay. We have lots and lots of scraps. Let's get these all out here in their different color piles. This is so fun. I love this. All right, we've got some shiny red. That one's satin. That one's shiny, satin, satin. Shiny, shiny. People are saying they love the trimmer, yay. Yeah, it's just such a good one. Okay, textured gold, satin green, more textured gold. All right, and now we're into the shiny gold. They all turned over upside down. All of this just looks like Christmas to me. Can you believe Christmas is a week away? It's insane. It's been both the fastest year and the slowest, right? It's just been crazy. Okay, and then these are all the solid colors. And you know what? I didn't cut out any red, but I think I'm good. I've got plenty of red between those three. All right. Okay. So here's what I'm working with. So, how am I going to do this? Okay, let's see here. I'm just gonna use, you know, I wish I had some like really thin computer paper nearby. I'd have to pull it out of my printer though. I guess I still could. Now we'll just use this. I've got some My Sweet Petunia grid paper. I'm gonna move this up like this so I have a little bit of workspace right here. And what I'm just gonna start like gluing these down. I'm gonna use a little bit of tape runner adhesive. Got some Tombow Extreme adhesive. And unfortunately, you just have to put adhesive like all over this, because if you're going to be die cutting it all or cutting it down to a different size, you just really want that adhesive everywhere, you know? You don't want any gaps. Okay, so I have that down, and now I can just start assembling. I think I'm gonna start with a nice, thick glitter one. Just place that down. Someone's asking about classes for lettering with watercolor. I don't have any specifically like that, but there is a little bit of lettering and watercolor in both Simply Watercolor and Simply Watercolor Christmas. There are links to both classes down below in the video description. All right, I think maybe I'll grab one of these. Oh, I don't like those greens together. I might not use that lighter green. We might just use the specialty green. All right, let's try a shiny gold. Followed by, you know, I might not use the plain cardstock. I might just use all the specialty cardstocks now that I'm more into it, you know? And I don't have very many of the satin red. I might have to cut some. Come up, you're not straight. There we go. That adhesive is very, very sticky. Zoom in a little bit for this. I feel like I'm building wrapping paper. Okay. All right. I feel like I do need green. Maybe I will go back to this green over here. No, I don't like it. But maybe I will take a really skinny of the satin green. All right. And then we will take some shiny red. This is just gonna scream Christmas. We need a glitter. We only did the glitter with the red, so we're gonna put them side by side. Okay, so story time, right? I'm gonna tell you a story since we're all just sitting here. Some of you may have heard this. I think I shared it on Instagram, maybe? I don't entirely remember exactly where I've shared it, but when I was a kid, I was very sneaky and I wanted to know what my gifts were. I was probably like, oh, I don't know, probably 7 or 8 years old, and I knew where my mom was hiding my gifts. So she was gone. I was the only one home. I'm not sure what instigated me being home alone, but I was home by myself. And I thought, you know what, I'm gonna go search the bedroom closet and find my gifts. Now, the problem with this whole theory of mine is that in my family, my parents would not put the name of the child the gift was for on the gift. Instead, we each would have a specific wrapping paper. And so you didn't know whose gift was whose until the morning of Christmas when you'd come down the stairs and there would be a stocking draped over the presents, and it had, the stocking had a name on it, and then you know that it was your presents. Well, that year I really wanted this particular type of baby doll that had, like, it was a newborn doll and it had a diaper on it, and you take the diaper off and you put it in water and something would dissolve, and then it would have like a birth certificate and it would tell you what the gender of your baby doll. So I'm like, sweet, you know, I really want this doll. And I'd asked for it for Christmas. I was really, really gung-ho on getting this baby doll. So I'm standing in front of my mom's closet. I'm looking up at the very top shelf. I don't know what, you know, which gift it would be, but I had seen the doll at my local store and I knew the size of the box. And so I was like, I think that's it. So I pull it down and I needed some supervision. I had a steak knife, and I used a steak knife and like slid it underneath the scotch tape to open it up. And so I open it up and sure enough, it is a doll. I am so excited. I'm so pumped. I cannot wait for Christmas morning. I know it's gonna be amazing and awesome. And this doll is just gonna like rock my world. So Christmas morning comes. Oh, first of all, I wrap it back up. I put the scotch tape. I even remember making sure that the tape was the same length as the tape that was already on the gift. I was sneaky, y'all. This is probably where my craftiness started, trying to make sure that my mom would not know that I had looked in the gifts. So replace the tape, put it back up in the closet. I'm like, this is awesome. Like, I'm gonna get my baby doll. Okay, so here's one. Isn't that pretty? Just looks like classic Christmas. I love that. I think in the next one, I'm gonna do even more of the glittery red. I think it's gonna be gorgeous. So, oh yeah, Carissa, I was a sneaky little thing. So Christmas morning comes. You know the other shoe's gonna drop in this story, right? Christmas morning comes. And I come downstairs, I'm all excited. I'm so, so excited for this dang doll. So I come down the stairs and I'm like, there's the doll. I recognize the gift wrap. And I walk into the room and I swear, it's just like, wah, wah, wah. My sister's stocking is draped over the baby doll box. And I'm eyeing it like, why is her stocking next to my gift? What is going on? Now, this is my older sister who was 2 years older than me. She was, you know, she still kind of played with dolls, but she was like, you know, it was not for very much longer. Like she, in fact, I probably was even a little older than that. I played with dolls until I was like 12. It's the imagination. It's like making up stories. Anyway, so I probably was even older than what I thought I said earlier. So anyway, I'm out of adhesive. I'm sitting there just like, slowly dying inside because no one knows that I saw the gift. No one knows that I snuck into my mom's closet and opened the gift thinking it was mine. Hold on, I gotta grab adhesive. Gotta get some refill. Okay, so I'm sitting there dying inside. I'm sure I had lovely gifts that year too. I don't remember what they were, but this is like trauma, right? Okay, so my sister opens the gift. She's like, oh, yay, doll. I'm sure she had a much better reaction. But in my memory, she's like, oh, yay, doll. You know, like she didn't even care. I was the one who had asked for the doll for Christmas. So I'm like, well, maybe she'll let me play with it. You know, like I was just trying to be a good sport, trying to pretend that I had not for a short time believed that I would receive the doll. So, oh, I love that. Dora says, I still play with dolls with my daughter. See, I would love it. Okay, so anyway, my sister opens up the doll. I'm like excited because I want to know what the gender of the doll is. She opens it up. She takes out the little diaper thing or whatever. She puts it in the water and it's supposed to reveal like boy or girl. Kid you not, it says twins. Here's this form. Fill it out. You'll get a second doll. So I'm thinking, sweet, I'm going to get the other doll. Not so. Because my sister didn't know how much I wanted this dang doll. So she kept both dolls. The moral of this story is, don't go sneaking around Christmas. You don't know if that gift is for you unless your name is on it. And even until the day of, that name could switch. You don't know. The other moral of this story is that we all of us have little things that only affected us as children that no one knows about. Now, okay, this story doesn't completely end there because both of my sisters, I have two sisters, both older than me, they heard this story because I think I shared it on Instagram a couple years ago. So Christmas morning comes. This is like 2 years ago Christmas. So it must have been like 2018 Christmas. I open this gift from my sisters. They've never like teamed up to give me a gift before, or not that I remember, so this was unusual. I open up the box. Seriously, it's like out of a movie. It's the doll. They went on eBay and they found the doll. And of course they had some that were like unopened that you could do, like figure out the gender thing, but they were like crazy expensive. So they got me one that was already used. But it's the doll. Isn't that funny? So I opened it up, but even still had like it has like a my first year book that you fill out for your doll and you fill out your name and all this stuff. And some other little girl had filled it out and she'd given the doll a name and like all this stuff. Anyway, it's super cute. I still have the doll. Every once in a while when my nieces come over, they play with it. But isn't that cute? My sisters were like, we had no idea you were traumatized. I'm like, yeah. Okay, let's find a glitter one. So that's one of my favorite Christmas stories to tell because it's just funny and silly, and it just shows, you know, how sneaky and dumb I was. But anyway, Carissa, it's like the scene from The Santa Claus too. Yeah, kind of, you know, where you're finally getting the gift that you wanted as a child. Oh, I hardly have any green on this. I better put a nice thick green piece. This one looks good. Anyway, that's one of my favorite Christmas stories. All right, I'm gonna put a little more on this. I think I'm gonna do, I haven't done any of the shiny red yet. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do a really skinny gold. And then I will do a really chunky, shiny red. All right, so this one just has wider strips altogether. How fun though, right? Okay, so I've got two done. I think I could at least get one more out of this. So while we're going here, I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Oh, Cecile saying she heard this story a couple years ago and she's happy for the update. Yeah, my sisters probably wouldn't have known that I was like, you know, hung up on this doll from years ago if I hadn't told it on Instagram. Maybe it wasn't a video. I can't remember. It might have been in a video. I'm trying to think if there were any other. Well, Sally says, my kids, okay, let me put it on screen here. Sally says, my kids' gifts didn't go out until they were asleep Christmas Eve. We had an old chest deep freeze in the basement that we didn't use. I hid the gifts in there and then locked it. Ooh, sneaky. They were teenagers before they figured it out. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, if you guys have good hiding places, tell us in the comments, where are you stashing your gifts? My mom, I'm pretty sure she figured out that I was rifling through the gifts. She then started putting them in the trunk of her car, right? Because she would, you know, wherever she was going, she'd be with it. Oh, Carol, I have a very similar story about peeking in my parents' closet, but my siblings were home with me and tattled. Then I did not receive the gift I peeked at, a cassette player back in the 70s. Oh, that sucks. You're like, narcs. Okay, let's make this one a little bit more predominantly green since the other ones were mostly red. All right, so we are gonna do some glitter. Oh, people are stashing their gifts at their neighbors. Like right now, I've got stocking stuff for my mom and also my fiance. It's just, they're in bags down on the kitchen counter. Like, they're not looking. Of course, if my fiance's watching, he might be like, oh, sweet, I'll go look. Next time I'm down there. Okay, I forgot. We're doing more green. Okay. Oh, wait. You're not on there straight. Come back. Okay. Oh, Judy, sounds like she learned from her mistakes. I tried that at about the same age. I got a Clue game. There was so much guilt and it was so anticlimactic. I never did it again. Judy learned her lesson. I don't like try to sneak and see what I'm getting because I generally can't. Everything's usually wrapped by the time I do. And I haven't been as gutsy to unwrap something like I did before. But, now the hard part for me is if I've got a really good gift for someone, I'm like, I just want them to open it right away. I'm like, hurry up, just open it. It's hard for me to keep it a secret. All right, let's see. Seeing if I want to do any more of this gold over here. Yeah, I'll do this one. Let's see, I think we'll do shiny red, and then green, and then we better get another glitter in here. Glitter, and then green. Okay, so this one definitely has more green. This one's a pretty good mix, I think, right? And then this one's a pretty good mix as well. So I've got enough for three cards here. I could probably even do a fourth. Should we stretch it? Let's do a fourth while we're here, right? We're only a half hour in, we got time. Okay, let's see. Oh, I think this comment is a classic. I used to sneak past my parents' room on Christmas Eve to see what Santa brought. Then I'd shake my brother's bed to wake him up and run back to my bed. Mm-hmm. I am pretty sure that is a story that was played out in many a household. Right? Janice, Christina, you sound just like my daughter. She can't wait for people to open their gifts. I know everything I'm getting already. See, like, I don't even mind, like, you know, not being surprised opening my gifts. Like, it's all about other people opening their gifts for me. So, and I just don't handle surprises well. Like, for real, getting proposed to. I even knew it was coming and I had a bad reaction. It is so embarrassing. You're never talking about it. My fiance and I have seen the video and we both decided it has never seen the light of day. So yeah, it was very awkward, but sweet. Good memory. Yeah, I do not do well being surprised. And I've told all my friends, don't surprise me. Don't do anything to surprise me because I just do not react well. I just don't know how to react, and then I react poorly. So, like, you know, don't surprise me. Okay, let's see here. We'll start down here. We'll just get a pretty good mix. You know what? And maybe I will. Should I mix in the other green? I don't really like those green tones together, but let's just mix them in. We'll do some of the other strips. It might be nice to have just kind of like a plain cardstock in here. Oh no, come on. Just tore the paper. That's okay. And we'll do a skinny gold. Super sticky adhesive. Okay. Can try blue in there? No. Scrapping the blue idea. But I will continue with the ones I already have now. All right, we'll try this one. And then we'll do another green, a darker green this time. Glittery red. And I think I'll do a shiny red. It'll be really pretty. And I think I have enough room for one more. Let's do this other gold. Okay. All right, so I've got four little DIY pattern groupings. And I have plans for, like, I thought ahead a little bit for some of it. I could really probably do a fifth one if I wanted here. That came together so quickly. But let's do some die cutting. Okay, let's see here. All right, I'm gonna get out A2 Layers by Waffle Flower so that I can get the perfect dimensions for this. Okay. Oh, that'll be perfect. I don't think I want that one though. I think I'll do it on this one. Okay. Oh, I can see the grid paper. Dang it. On this gold one right here. Maybe I'll purposely put a greeting over top right there. Okay. You know what? I don't know that I can fit. I'm not gonna be able to fit this through my die cutting machine, so I'm just gonna trim. Now it should be just fine. All right, I'll be back. Hopefully this will cut okay. It's kind of thick. I'm just die cutting if anyone's coming in right now. Okay, it did cut through, thankfully. Oh, and it put all, can you see all the marks on that? That's from my plate. It'll be fine. I have a plan. I can put something over the top of this. But for these other ones, I will just make sure to put a piece of paper on top. And it will keep it nice and clean. Okay. I think I'll cut this one out as well. Someone's telling me it's not straight. You know what? It's okay if it's not straight. You could even make it on purposely not straight. Skew it. Maybe I'll do that on one of these. All right. So now when I run it through, oh, I keep forgetting. I need to cut it down. Maybe I'll just do this right now. There we go. And then I'll put that on top and then I'll run it through again. Just kidding. I can't do that. I have to cut this down. I keep forgetting the paper's too big. Now I can run it through. That was super thick. I'm waiting for my Gemini to be like, nope, not cutting. You know what? It still got indentations. I think it's because it's so thick. You know, see, look at that. It still has indentations. That's okay. They'll still be pretty. All right, so I've got these two that are ready. And then I think for these other ones, I think I'm gonna cut out hearts. You know, just for something a little different. First of all, I'm gonna cut this down. This is actually big enough. I probably could do a 5x7. Yeah, let's do that. And then I'll use this one with the hearts. So now I'm gonna break out. Hello. Die cuts are coming down from the sky. A7 layers from Waffle Flower. I better put back this other one first so I don't lose it. All right, and then I think I could be able to get something. Will that be big enough? Nope. Or rather, small enough. I think that one could work. Okay, to make sure, are these adhered all the way to the edge? Not quite. So I'll just cut from right there. That'll hold that in place, like that. I'm gonna not use the metal shim this time. I'm hoping maybe it won't have as much pressure and it will still cut, but it won't leave all the indentations. I'm I'm also going to turn my plates over. That might help too. Got it without any weird marks this time, and it still cut through. Lovely. All right, and then I think just for something different, I'm gonna use a heart on this one. All right. So, let's see here. Looking for my nested hearts from Simon. Keep them by my work area. Oh my word, where are all my dies going? Oh wait, no, nope, that circles. Well, crap. I am losing everything, you guys, today. Well, maybe we'll be doing a circle. Interesting. Where would my heart dies have gone? That is really odd. All right, one more look through where it should be. Oh, found it. Yay. Okay, nested hearts. How far did the adhesive go over? Oh, only to about right there. So I bet we could do this size of heart. I wouldn't be able to get all of the colors on there, but I'd get most of them if I did a bigger heart. I think I'd run into the areas that aren't adhered. Yeah. Oh, but I would love that one right there. Wouldn't that be pretty? Guess I'll have to do the smaller one. That's okay. And I think I do want it kind of at a diagonal a little bit. Like that. I think that'd be really pretty. Alrighty. Okay. If I can use this other half over the top. There we go. Oh, the heart is so cute. Heart is really cute. Look how cute that is. I love these just like really traditional holiday colors. It's fun. Okay, let me clean up this area a little bit so I can think. We get to think about what we're doing with all of these. Well, I know I want a white card base for most of them. Just easier, you know? All right, so I'm gonna prep my 5x7. There we go. Oh, how pretty. So Christmassy. All right, and then I think I'll do A2 cards for the other three. So I'm gonna prep these. All Okay, what is this? Marie saying, can also buy rolls of magnetic material like what's used to make large magnetic signs or cards. Pretty expensive. Oh, I think she's talking about for storing dies. Alrighty. Now I think I can sit down. I was standing up, so I'm going back and forth to my die cutting machine. Oh, there's a little tape on this one still. Pull that off. All right. Oh, how pretty is that? Prep this one as well. I'm going to be putting like popping up gratings that go on top. So I'm going to go ahead and adhere all of these to the card fronts. How cute is that? Using foam adhesive while I've got them all out like this. There we go. Now you can see more of what I'm working with. I am not holding back when it comes to foam tape, especially since these are, will be meld. So look at my little roll. It's all the way down to the bottom. Good thing I have. Guess how many backups of this foam tape I have. Just guess. I'm going to let you guys in the comments guess how many backups I have. I heard someone say that they were discontinuing these rolls. I don't know if that's true because I keep finding them everywhere and they're still being sold. So maybe that's not true. But I heard that there was going to be a shortage soon. So I stocked up. Guess how many rolls of the Big Mama foam roll I got. I just saw them today and counted them. So Cecile saying 3, Sally saying 6. Oh, we've got some other ones. 14. Oh, 24. No. 41. No. I am not that ambitious. Okay. I have 6. Oh, no, wait. Sorry. No, I have 5. I have 5 rolls. And now you're making me think I should probably order some more because now we're all going to be running over to Amazon to buy it, right? I thought 5 was excessive. At least I don't have as many rolls of foam tape as I have pads of Arches watercolor paper. Oh my word. I swear that stuff breeds like rabbits. You have one pad of it, and then you add a second pad, and suddenly you've got 5. I don't know how it works like that. Okay. Oh, so many good guesses. There's a shortage because I have them all. Too funny. Oh, Cecile's saying it was originally made for car repair. Don't think it will be discontinued anytime soon. Well, I think what they were saying was not that it was going to be discontinued, but they were going to be repackaging it in smaller rolls. And so it would be harder to get like a Big Mama roll. So, I don't know. They were just going to change it. Sometimes I can't be bothered to put these little release papers in the garbage. I just make a pile, and then I'll pick them all up at once later. There we go. Okay. This one. Ta-da. Getting close. Stop buying. Yeah, I know, right? The width of this tape, I think it's half an inch. Is it half an inch? It might be a little more. Nope, it's exactly half an inch. They do sell wider versions, but I find the half inch to be easier to work with. There's that one. And then we have the heart. No, I do want to make a portrait. Okay. So now, after I throw these all away, I need to figure out what greetings I'm doing. I'm gonna put some stuff away so it's clearing off my area. Janice just jumped on Amazon and grabbed one. Yeah, I tried to order, I think I had to place three different Amazon orders because the seller I was getting them from had capped how many you could buy in one order. So I think you could only buy like two rolls at a time or something like that. Okay. Put those away. All right. So I thought I would use this stamp set from CZ Design. She's got some really fun ones. And there's also some dies, which could be helpful. So, yeah. Go ahead and get these out. I was thinking maybe I could like stamp directly on the strips, but then I use like glitter and foil paper, so that won't really work. But let's see, would this Be of Good Cheer look good on that one? I think it might. Like put it on vellum or something. I think that could be really pretty. Okay. All right, I think I'm just gonna do three or four greetings and stamp and die cut them out and then just put them on cards and call it a day. It doesn't have to be complicated. We're doing easy cards today, right? Okay. But I do think I want to do that Be of Good Cheer on vellum. So we're going to do that first. Got to grab some vellum. All right. Got to die cut it so it doesn't matter if it's not quite cut right. Okay. All right, and I'm going to emboss in gold, I think. I think that would look really nice on all of these. So, let's see, anti-static powder tool. Versamark ink. Now these are very dainty lines on this font, so I'm going to be very careful as I stamp them. Oh no, all the Big Mama rolls are sold out now. That's too funny. Well, I'm glad some of you got the last few. All right. Oh, Christina, close your Misty first. I always get embossing powder in my Misty because I don't close it first. Right, that's beautiful. I'm gonna hold that with my tweezers while I heat it with my heat tool. And I'm gonna hold my heat tool off to the side while it's on for just a minute so that it heats up so that I'm not spending the time that it's heating up like pointing at the vellum and possibly warping it even more. So this is where we're at. I'm going to be moving it around a lot, going from side to side. All Okay. I love gold embossing on vellum. Doesn't it just look pretty? Okay, I've got one little spot I need to heat because it wasn't hot enough. There we go. All right, love that. Okay. Going to stamp the other ones and then I can die cut all at the same time. And I'm thinking the other ones, should I have them on the vellum? I think I'm just gonna have them on white. All right. Getting some white cardstock. There we go. And I'm gonna do season's greetings, Merry Christmas, and Happy Christmas. And I can die cut them all at the same time. Okay. Make sure that's in the corner. Anti-static powder tool. Inking that up really well. Making sure I walk over each area. Okay. Back to the gold embossing powder, and I'm closing my Misty, consciously telling myself don't put the powder on with the door open. Over here, but that's okay because it's outside of the area that will be die cut anyway. Okay. All right, let's get all this die cutting prepped. I'm just going to take these off my door. Season's greetings. Merry Christmas. Happy Christmas. Doing four cards, I feel like it's like a marathon session. Okay. All right. Now I've got to separate these dies. I just use wire cutters. Like most people who are like doing beading would have these. Some of these I can take apart just like this. Okay, I don't think I'm using any of those. It's these three. All right, there's one. I hold the dies over a trash can when I cut them usually because you don't want any of the little metal pieces flying around that can injure you. I've had some like get wedged in my skin and it bleeds. So just be careful. So like I'll take this one that has all the little arms and I'll go to my trash can and put it inside and then cut from there. And I also close my eyes when I do it. Okay, get it started. Close my eyes and then snap it because I'm paranoid. Alrighty, so this is the perfect size for our lovely Be of Good Cheer. So I'm gonna get this on here just right. This one is the Merry Christmas. Sorry if my head is in the way. All right, and then this one is Happy Christmas. Season's greetings. All right. Run these through my die cutting machine and I'll be right back. Pop this one out. Oh, it didn't want to cut this last little corner. That's okay. I will remove the die. Thankfully, because it's vellum, I can see the other side, so it will not be a problem to just cut it with an X-Acto knife. Just like so. These I think will pop right out. So cute. I love CZ Designs little greetings like this. They always turn out awesome. All right, let's decide what is going where. Okay, I think the Be of Good Cheer would look awesome on that one, right? And I think I'm gonna put the Happy Christmas on that one. I'll do Merry Christmas here. And maybe I'll turn this one and do Season's Greetings like that. I think that's a pretty good mix. And really simple looking cards. All right, time for more of this foam adhesive. And this time I'm going to use my scissors and cut them down a little bit. Except this one, I'm going to have to put liquid glue behind the words in just strategic places. And that will make it so it's not too obvious that there's foam adhesive, or that there's adhesive behind it. Not foam, just regular adhesive. Okay. Tweezers end up. Here we are. Yeah, you can really see, you probably can't see it on camera as much, but like the indentations from the cutting plates just makes me laugh. There we go. Happy Christmas. Perfect. Season's greetings. In fact, I could probably just do a regular adhesive strip on this one. And then cut these. Perfect. Alrighty. This one's gonna go in the bottom corner. And then on this one, I'm first going to get my vellum piece on my tweezers. Then I'm coming in with some Gina K Designs Connect Glue down to the tail end of this. Hopefully I can get it to work. I might not be able to get it to work. Like, I can see there's not much glue left in the bottle. Okay. We are taking a slight break to open up a package I got from Honeybee. I just ordered stuff from them and I have some of their adhesive. I haven't tried their adhesive before, but it kind of looks like it's similar to the Gina K, but maybe a bigger bottle. We're gonna try it out. Yeah, look at that. Goes on white, dries clear. Sounds great to me. All right, I need scissors, some smaller ones to open this up. Where? Oh, they're over here by the box. Hello. Tip them over to open the box. Generally how I like to adhere vellum is I'll run it through my Xyron Create a Sticker machine, but it's going on top of glitter paper and foil, and I just don't know if it would adhere quite the same. All right, here we go. Honey, it's a nice bottle. All right, so a little too much. It had a little pressure in the bottle. Yeah, let's get some scratch paper. Kinda get the air out a little. Okay. So I'm just getting like little tiny dabs of glue and little corners. It's okay if it shows, not a big deal. There's a little pressure, air pressure in the bottle. So I'm not even squeezing it right now and I have glue coming out. So sometimes I just have to dab it off on the side. Come on, get all the air out. Sometimes you can do this and it pushes all the air to the top. And then you won't have glue coming out when you don't want it to. To play with that later. Because like, I'm not even squeezing it and it's still coming out. I think it's pressurized from coming through the mail. Okay. Kind of have a big glob right there, so I'm gonna, I don't know, it might just have to show. Alrighty. Just right here. Looks really good. You kind of see it right there. Love that. All right. So those are the cards for today. They're like blinding on camera. It's hilarious. All right. Hello, I'm back. Hope you all enjoyed the cards today. I think they turned out super cute. My favorite is that Be of Good Cheer, I think, because it just came out so dang cute. Let's see, any questions in the comments? Let's see here. Dora says they look like presents without bows. That is a really good point. I guess if you wanted to, you could add a little string and make it into a present. That'd be really pretty. All right. Love them. I love them too. The last one was your favorite. Yeah, that's the Be of Good Cheer is my favorite. Not too many questions at the end of today's live. Thanks for joining me today. We covered a lot. Foam adhesive, where to buy it, where to find it. I like the Scotch 3M. I saw some people in the chat recommending that you pick it up at like a hardware store, or like a Home Depot or Lowe's. I have it there as well. I don't know if they have the really big rolls, but I know they have them. Yeah. And thank you for those of you who this was your first live. Thank you for joining and tuning in. Thank you all so much for joining today. Just a reminder that today's cards are day 24 of the holiday card series. Day 25 will go up on Monday, and then on Wednesday I will be live at noon for another live stream. I'm not sure what we're gonna make, probably a holiday DIY something of some sort. But I'll be back on Wednesday next week, not on Friday, because Friday is actually Christmas. So I'll be back on Wednesday at noon. So I hope you'll join me. Oh, someone asked about the washi tape. It's actually Crafters Essentials Easy C tape. I will link it down below. As soon as I hop offline here, I always update the description down below with supplies for everything I use. I will include it in the link, or you can just go back to my last video, Wednesday's video from 2 days ago. I used it in that video too, and it is in the supply section for that video. All right. I think that's all of the questions. Someone's wondering about spray adhesive to adhere vellum. Yes, the whole idea why spray adhesive would work, or why the Zarin Crate sticker would work, is because you're applying adhesive to the entire surface of the vellum. You could do that with a liquid adhesive. That's how I first did it. In fact, it was the Hero Arts glue that's similar to this glue. You just put glue all over the vellum, and then you use your finger to like smear it all the way across. Or you could use like paper or something, but you smear it so you have like a whole layer of adhesive over the vellum, and then you adhere the whole thing all at once. The whole idea is, you know, if the adhesive covers everything, you're not gonna tell that there's adhesive there because you can't see the edges of the adhesive. It's the edges of the adhesive that show when you try to adhere vellum. So if there are no edges, then you can't see it. So that's the whole theory. Andrew is asking about the Pilot envelope addressing pen. They've discontinued it, sadly. One of my lovely subscribers / viewers sent me some from her stash. She had a bunch and she sent me some. So I'm good for a while, but I'm on the lookout for pens that are similar, and I haven't quite found one yet. All right, well, I think I'm gonna close up the video for today. Thank you so much for joining me. Reminder, I'll be back on Monday with day 25, and come and join me on Wednesday when we're back here live. And if you have any requests for what you want me to do live, let me know now in the live chat or in the comments later. Let me know what you want to see. I really loved how you guys kind of suggested last week that I do kind of like that really easy watercolor, which turned out so cute. So many of you sent examples of what you've made using the same techniques that I showed, and I loved it so much. So if you have a suggestion or a question you want answered in a video, something like that, leave a comment and I'll be sure to see it. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the last video for the holiday card series, day 25. See you Monday.